Welcome back. It is Thursday, March 7th in the NBA. Five picks are on the way. What's going on? It is Austin joined by Logan. We are going to recap how we did yesterday. Man, it should have been a winning day, but it was a 1-2 day. We will talk about why should it have been a winning day, because we lost on the Wizards plus 8.5. I'm not going to let Logan go on a rant. He did that pre-show because they were up 21 points, and then they obviously lost by 10. Rushed a bucket short. Just terrible. I mean, when you bet on trash teams, you're sometimes going to get trash results, and that was one of them. But, man, they should have covered. Our winner of the day was Fox. He delivered pretty easily in points plus assists. I think he had 44 points. And the Bulls team total under 113.5. The Jazz gave up 119. Of course, they covered, which was Logan's, you know, lean in that game, taking the Jazz plus the points. But either way, a 1-2 day. We're not going to complain about it. You know, it's up 42 units. Let's dive in. We got five picks today. We're not going to waste any more of your time, but I do want to put in two notes. Number one, if we go 5-0 today, we're doing a giveaway. You got to just hit that subscribe button. That's free. And you got to hit that like button. If you're already subscribed, give yourself a pat on the back. We appreciate you. We're trying to hit 200,000 subscribers. And when we hit 200K, we're definitely doing a giveaway. So make sure you hit that subscribe button. And number two, on the second channel, top link in the description, we have a new video popping up. It should be live. I'll say around 10 a.m. Eastern time, it'll be live for my second, honeymoon type video. Really cool things we've done in New Zealand. I really like how the video turned out. Definitely check it out and just go show the second channel some love. It's the top link in the description underneath my name, Austin O'Connell. Go show it some love. But I'm going to dive into the picks. First one of the day is going to be the guy that's on the thumbnail giving you a heart. This is Mr. Nikola Jokic, over 24.5 points, minus 125 on FanDuel. Now, before you log into your book and you're like, Austin, the line's 25.5 or 26.5, maybe on some books. Yeah, the line actually was 25.5, but I'm going to take, you know, the 25-plus point milestone for Jokic in this spot. And for a couple different reasons, the reason I'm taking the milestone, laying a little bit more juice, is because, well, Jokic has landed on 25 points on the dot six times this season. That's obviously a big number for him, big number for really any player. So I'm willing to lay up to about minus 135, maybe minus 140 if you're throwing it in a parlay, just because I'd rather secure that milestone number than having to take the 25.5 or 26.5. Look, I've been on the bad end of taking a 25.5, seeing a guy end with 25 points and be like, yep, that sounds about right. The books are that are pretty sharp this far into the year. But I really like Jokic, obviously, at home tonight against Boston. We know how good Boston is. They're going to be able to put up points against the Nuggets. And we've seen Jokic this season. When you kind of see him turn it on, it's normally against the good teams. And there aren't many teams better than the Boston Celtics in the NBA this season. And Jokic has come to play against Boston. His last three against them, 29, 30. And then this season, scored 34 points against Boston, even in the game in which Jamal Murray had, I think, 35 points. Hence why a lot of people will be on Murray tonight. But this season, Jokic, 25 points or more in 41 of 60 games. And when he shoots at least 15 times, aka he's being aggressive, that number balloons up to 81% of the time, averaging a little over 29 points per game. Look, there's no reason for Jokic to not be aggressive tonight. The Celtics, a really, really good defensive team. They don't give up a lot of catch and shoot threes. They are going to make you beat them one-on-one. And there's fewer players on the Nuggets that you want going one-on-one other than Nikola Jokic. He's also dominated Kristaps going over this line in five straight matchups versus Porzingis. I really think this is a good spot to back Jokic. So I really like his over in points. I'm not going to get cute and try to add on points plus rebounds or points plus assists. I just want to put the ball in the basket. Like I said, I'm taking the milestone number 25 plus points, but I also like it at 25.5. And heck, I like it up to 26.5. Now, before I go to Logan for his favorite pick, I'm going to dive into another pick because I got four of them of the slate today. So I'm going to do two, then give Logan the reins, and then give you another two. I really like Kyrie Irving tonight. I like his over 29.5 points plus assists. This is one that I'm fine tacking on the assists. His line is 25.5 points. If you're like, Austin, I can only bet individual lines. Points is the way to go for Kyrie. We obviously are going to need him to put up about 23, 24 points. There is a chance he could have a big assist game, but I think the points is the way to go. I just think his assists are due a little bit of regression, and we'll talk about that in the analysis. But like I said, Kyrie, I really like him tonight against Miami. They're at home, so I like that. But against Miami, we know Miami, a really tough defensive team, and I think they're going to try their hardest to make life difficult on Luka Doncic, the guys that are obviously are always having fun with each other during the All-Star break. But we know the Heat, what do they do? A lot of double teaming, and I wouldn't be surprised if they double team and throw a lot of bodies at Luka, and I think it's going to lead to Kyrie getting some good usage. And regardless of if, you know, Luka's been insane, he's been putting up, you know, 38 point triple doubles, and they've still been losing, but still, Kyrie's been good regardless of that. He's still averaging 26.7 points per game and over 4.5 assists per game. Good for 31 points plus assists in the last 13 games when he returned back from injury, going over in 10 of 13. Something I love about Kyrie, rarely, knock on wood, has a bad shooting night. In fact, during this last 13-game stretch, only four games has he shot below 50% from the field. And the previous four, the fourth one actually being his last game, previous three, bounced back easily at 32 or more points plus assists. In the next game, Kyrie's hit this over in two straight versus Miami. And I just think this is a spot where we can see him put the ball in the basket, but I also think his assists are due some regression. His last like 10 games, he's not had a ton of high assist games, but he's been averaging about 9 potential assists, just converting them into assists at like a 40% clip. I think he's due some regression for his teammates to knock down more shots. I would think this is a good spot to back Kyrie Irving. Is it a great spot where he's facing, you know, a traffic cone defense? No, but I think a traffic cone defense doesn't necessarily cater a ton to Kyrie Irving's skills. I think you need guys that are actually going to play defense and guard everyone on the court, where it's like, all right, the ball's going to end up in Kyrie's hands at the end of the shot clock. Go get us a bucket. That's what we know Kyrie's capable of doing. So my first two props of the day, Jokic is over in points. Kyrie Irving's over in points plus assists. Logan, I need a POD winner from you. What do you got?
Yeah, I only got one pick. You got four, but I really do like the pick that I do have. I'm taking the Pacers on the money line, minus 120 odds on Bet365, currently your best value there. Now, if you can bet this on Bet365, do it. Not only is that a great book for a lot of odds, but they also offer an early payout if the team leads by 20-plus points, which, you know what? Chokes happen. I was on the wrong end of a choke last night with the Washington Wizards. Would have loved to have an early payout there. So things happen. Hopefully the Pacers are not choking for us today. I like the Pacers to get the outright win at home in this spot earlier in the season. Minnesota won 127 to 109 in Minnesota. Terrible showing from the Pacers really in that one. They didn't play a whole lot of defense. And a big difference in this matchup today, no Karl Anthony Towns for the T-Wolves. In that December matchup, Cat was the leading scorer for the T-Wolves with 40. So that's going to be a pretty big loss in this one. That's why this game is priced as a pick 'em. The Timberwolves opened as slight favorites, has now flipped to where the Indiana Pacers are now the slight favorites in that one. But Anthony Edwards had 37 in that game. He's going to be tasked to carry a huge load once again in Indiana, because where's the scoring going to come from? You're going to really need the role players to step up outside of Anthony Edwards. And since the Pacers are at home, I think their offense and role players are the key advantage here. They've been a juggernaut at home for most of the year. Outside of Edwards too, Gobert, Conley, and McDaniels only combined for 15 points in that matchup. Pacers offense has the tools and the skill set to definitely run this Timberwolves team out of the gym. Indiana, first in points scored at home, first in field goal percentage, and three-point percentage. They're really good at home as well. This team just knows how to get out in the fast break, play really fast, get guys open shots. I really like this Pacers team a whole lot offensively. It's always the defense that kind of, you know, is the pause for us there. But the strength of the Timberwolves is defense, but being just 16th in opponents' three-point made percentage on the road, they could easily get run out of the gym. I mentioned, if they give Indiana these open looks, if they're trading twos for threes, Indiana is the type of team to do that. I think this is a great spot for backing Indiana. And even though the Wolves are 8 games better record-wise, I really like this matchup for Indiana. That's kind of why I think the Minnesota is a little bit overvalued. They are better record-wise. They've been a pretty decent team to bet on this year. But at home, the Indiana Pacers, they play different basketball there. Hopefully they play a little bit of defense today, just a little bit on Anthony Edwards. Hopefully all the shots do fall. I think the Pacers come out and win this game for us as my play of the day. But Austin, throwing it back to you.
Yep, and we're going to dive right into an under. No one likes unders, but I really like this one today. Hopefully it's as easy as our last one, the Mikal Bridges under was, because they're going to a guy that kind of has a similar game to Mikal Bridges. It's Devin Vassell. I like his under 24.5 points, minus 110 on DraftKings. Now, this is the highest line I've seen for Vassell really this season, and there's a good reason why. Obviously, he's been playing pretty well, you know, not necessarily consistently, but playing pretty well over the last month or so. And Victor Wembanyama is out, or at least out as we record this. Like I said, I can't guarantee anyone's out until the tip-off comes in and the guy's not playing. But I don't expect, obviously, Victor to play tonight, and neither do the books. They have listed him out on the injury report, which is why you see in a high line for Vassell. But I don't think necessarily that him being Victor being out helps Vassell. I mean, you think about how much defensive focus goes towards Wembanyama. It's literally all eyes are on him. Hence why, you know, he has some games where he's getting like 10 assists because everyone is focused on him and other guys are able to get open like Devin Vassell. Tonight, they don't have that defensive magnet where you're just seeing everyone's eyeballs focused on Wemby and, you know, Vassell can back cut or just get to his open looks. No, they're going to have their eyes on Devin Vassell trying to limit him. So while he might see a couple more looks, they're not going to be good quality looks. So I think they kind of balance out here. And I'm okay fading him. In fact, this season in six games without Wembanyama, Vassell has only scored above 20 points once, and that was 22. And he went under in all six of the games. And those all did occur in you know, December and January. They're obviously a different team now in March, but still worth noting. He did not necessarily take advantage of the higher usage with Wembanyama out. Now you look at the Spurs. Obviously, they do have the rest advantage here. They're facing a road that will on the road in Sacramento, taking on the Kings, who are on a road on a back-to-back, faced the Lakers last night and beat them. Now they're coming back here, but there's no guarantee. The Spurs on the road, you never know what you're getting from them. They're still 10.5 point underdogs. This could be a blowout, which Vassell will not play in blowouts in. I just think this is a good spot to fade him. You look at him, he has had two really good games against the Kings. He scored like 29 and 32 points in his last two versus them. Sure, if you tell me Devin Vassell shooting 58% and 72%, yeah, he's probably going over tonight. But you can't, I mean, like I said, guys are going to have good shooting nights. They're going to have bad shooting nights. I just don't love this line for him. I think this line's way too high for him. And they haven't really adjusted his three-pointers. They really don't think he makes a lot of threes tonight. In fact, his under 3.5 threes, minus 250. So they're really juicing that under. They're saying, hey, we may think maybe he makes three, which is about his line. His line's 2.5, minus 110. Like maybe he makes three, but we don't think he makes four. And this season, when he's made three or less, he's under this line in 86% of games. So, look, if he wants to go off shoot really efficiently, like we've had some guys when we take their unders, fine. Tip my cap to him, but I don't love the matchup. Probably sees Keegan Murray defensively, who's been a really good elite isolation defender. And hopefully that the Kings, if they want to double him, go for it too. Make someone else beat you. I really like Devin Vassell's under in points tonight. And then my fifth and final play of the day. Yes, we got five of them. If we go 5-0, we're doing a $100 giveaway. Just make sure you hit that subscribe button and drop a like too. We're talking all about a guy we bet on a couple days ago. Emmanuel Quickly, I really like his over 26.5 points plus assists, minus 115 on Bet365. Now, if you're concerned about a blowout, sure, you can avoid this bet as they are 10-point underdogs on the road in Phoenix. But like Logan and I always talk about, games are only blowouts when you don't expect them to be blowouts. Those are the 1 and 2 point spreads. Those are the ones that you see 35 point differences. I think the Raptors keep this game close, especially if they're just getting smoked. And even in a game that got smoked, Quickly got really close to this line. It still played about 33 minutes, but we talked about Quickly. We're like him because Scotty Barnes is out. Not only him now, Jakob Poeltl and Oshai Agbaji is potentially out. So they got a really bare-bones squad out there. Look, if you're a casual NBA bettor or NBA watcher, you probably don't know literally everyone on the Raptors bench. There is an absolute just skeleton crew down there. But I still really think this is just a spot where Quickly will do his thing. He's at 33 and 24 points plus assists the last two, obviously without Scotty. And we've talked about the Suns last seven games. Second most points per game to point guards, 10th most assists per game too. Quickly, about 14 potential assists these last two games. And we've seen point guards cook in this team. Just saw Jamal Murray had 37 points plus assists. SGA, 44. Those guys are pretty good. Fred VanVleet, 35. Many more guards have absolutely cooked him. So he has a really high floor for minutes. He played 33 in a game. They were trailing legitimately by 30 at halftime. I just think this is a good spot here. Quickly's been pretty good. I just think this line's tad too low. When they bump it up to 28.5, 29.5, I'm probably out on Quickly unless RJ Barrett dies and he's playing 48 minutes a game. But I really do think this is a spot that we can continue to target Quickly. I really like the points. I really like the assists. Combine on points plus assists. A lot of people will be on PRAs or maybe the rebounds, but or PRAs was 32.5. That's saying you need Quickly to get 7 rebounds to make it reasonable. And I'd rather not count on a short guard like him to get it done. So that's my final pick of the day. I know Logan, if he wants to touch on a couple spreads that he considered, they did involve a couple of players I already bet on. So we didn't really want to double down on, but Logan, I'll give you the liberty to talk about those two teams right now.
Yeah. The player props you had went in games that I was really considering picking, but that's okay. Cause you picked some of the star players on those teams. I was really considering Mavs -4.5. I think the Mavs actually win that game by 15 plus. So, but it goes hand in hand with your Kyrie pick. Cause if Kyrie doesn't do anything, there's a really good chance the Mavs do not cover that number. So I like them. I also leaned pretty hard to the Denver Nuggets. I just told you, I've said what I needed to say about this Boston Celtics team. They're a they're just a bad 3-point shooting night away from getting run out by a team as good as Denver is at home. If they're if Tatum and Brown aren't making those BS little step back threes and stuff, I think they get blown out. But you mentioned you like Nikola Jokic. That's to me the X factor in that game, because Kristaps Porzingis is a really, really good defender. And if he gets cooked by Jokic, well, that should be a pretty good Denver win and cover in that one. So I do like your player props, your player prop reads in that one. That's why I am only picking one game pick in this one. I'd rather just be one pick that I really do like. I know, you know, sometimes we want to force a ton of spreads and totals, but I just like my one pick today. Austin, I love your props today. I'm feeling 5-0 for the people, honestly.
Hey, 5-0 sweep. Like we said, $100 giveaway. All you got to do is hit that subscribe button and drop a like on the video. We certainly would appreciate it. Well, have a wonderful Thursday. Just a reminder, if you want to go show the second channel some love, new video should be popping up on that channel at 10 a.m. Eastern. So go check it out down below. Austin Logan signing out. We'll be back tomorrow with this Brooms out. And hopefully we will see you guys then. Peace.